happier news. I'm sure you know that on Sunday, right across the street from us here in Hollywood, and airing here on this very network, the 92nd Annual Academy Awards. It's like the West Coast version of the Iowa caucuses. There are 9 nominees for Best Picture this year, which is a lot of nominees. So we decided to have some fun. We went out in the street and we asked people about a bunch of stuff we made up about these nominated films. None of what we're about to describe happened, but did that stop people from giving their takes on them? Of course not. In a new Academy Awards edition of Lie Witness News.
We're out here talking to people about some of the Oscar movies from this last year. There was, of course, A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, Tom Hanks starring as Mr. Rogers. An incredible performance, yes? Now, were you surprised by the violent daylight bank robbery at the beginning of the film? What was it like to see Mr. Rogers holding a smoking gun?
You know, like, when I first turned on the movie, like, I was like, I didn't come for this, but it was, to me, it was quite, you know, exhilarating. For kids, it may have been
a little violent for children.
Especially Mr. Rogers, yeah.
Now, some people are thinking that Larry David should have been nominated for Best Supporting Actor for his appearance as the Riddler in Joker. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, he did really good performances in that movie, so yeah, I guess he may want the Oscar, yeah.
Do you think that the song Tonight We're Gonna Party Like It's 1917 deserved the nomination for Best Song?
Yes, absolutely. It's a feel-good song, and it's catchy, and it's good. It's definitely a feel-good song.
Renee Zellweger was nominated for
that. The message wasn't exact. I mean, they shouldn't make a movie out of something like that. I don't know. I think that that's a really terrible thing that happened, and it shouldn't be glorified.
We shouldn't be playing God like that.
No, I don't think so, man. I think that should be a whole nother thing.
Then, of course, there was Harriet, the story of Harriet Tubman. Do you think Ariana Grande was the right choice for the role?
I didn't think that she'd do a good job, but after seeing it, I think she fit it well. She could do it. Yeah, she did good.
Do you think she has a shot at the Oscar for that?
For an Oscar? I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Stick to singing, man.
Yeah. Stick to singing.
Things to each other from Impractical Jokers, the movie, and their TV show, too. Joe, James, Brian, and Sal, aka the Tenderloins, are here with us. And this is their forthcoming album. It's called Kelsey, because that is her name. Kelsey Ballerini from the Mercedes-Benz. This week on the show. Wow, we got quite a list of guests next week. Harrison Ford, Amy Poehler, Chris Pratt, Katy Perry, Lionel Richie, Luke Bryan, David Sedaris, Lucy Hale, Science Bob Flugfelder will be here, Huey Lewis will be here, we'll have music from Wiz Khalifa, Ty Dolla $ign, Lil Yachty, Sweka the Child, Andy Schauf, Super M, and Sam Hunt. So please join us for all that. I'm not getting too old for this job. Our first guest is an Emmy and Tony Award-winning man and the 9-time Oscar host against whom all others are measured. His new comedy, Standing Up, Falling Down, premieres in theaters and on VOD February 21st. Please welcome Billy Crystal. It's an honor to have you here, and I'm wondering what goes through your mind when you come into this neighborhood where you hosted the Oscars so many times.
Yeah.
And you see the street closed down, and you're maneuvering your way through. What do you think of?
Having been burned.
Hey, Rollins, right? It's Rollins. Hey, how you doing? Are you everyone? I get around.
What are you doing?
Honestly, I don't even know.
You killed Rory.
I didn't kill
That's
Rory.
Why you were stressed.
Were you shoulder right before you strangled him.
He already died of leukemia. He died of leukemia. Are you high?
Yeah.
Billy Crystal and Ben Schwartz standing out calling now. It's a very sweet movie, a nice relationship. Well, talk a little bit about your character.
I play Marty, who is an alcoholic, pot-smoking dermatologist. Which was very difficult for me because I'm not a dermatologist. And I think we've been guilty about it.
Okay.
When parking in a handicapped space, how long after you entered the car should you fake your limp?
Next, they shift their shenanigans to the big screen in Practical Jokers. The movie opens in theaters February 21st. Please welcome Joe Gatto, James Murray, Brian Quinn, and Sal Vocano, the Tenderloins. Kind of thing is right up my alley. So tell everyone how long you guys have been doing this stuff to each other.
we met as freshmen in high school in 1990.
Last year of high school.
First year.
Yeah. 1990.
Yeah.
And then you guys went your separate ways briefly, and you came.
And it was just hit after hit. It was polar and snake. It was opposite attract. And I just tell you, I fell for hook, line, and sinker. I had you all over my wall. It was you and George Michael. And God bless, and here we are right now. This is honestly, out of everything I've done in the show in a decade, this is the most uncomfortable I've ever been.
Well, not only do we have this rose and this beautiful meeting with Paula, but we've been able to get you, the two of you, a pair of tickets to the Sonic the Hedgehog.
Oh! Thanks,
Mom. Thank you. Impractical Jokers, the movie, opens in theaters February 21st. Thank you all for being here.
Dane. Ones that you watch. Let's take a look back at Series 8 really quickly, and then we'll get into the panel. Series 8 highlights Dr. Who!
Yeah. It's all good.